Hi students, today I am going to teach you the next chapter of our English course book, The Golden Touch. I hope you are understood the previous chapters, so please read that chapters twice and learn that word meaning and question answers. So let us move on to our next chapter, The Golden Touch. This lesson is about a very rich king whose desires will become the richest man in the world. It is very interesting and moral story. So let us start. Once upon a time, a long time ago in ancient Greece, there lived a king. His name Midas. He was very rich king and he was very fair and just. He ruled his kingdom very wisely. But unfortunately, his greed was far greater than his wisdom. His greatest desire was to be the greatest man in the world. And his desire was to be the greatest or richest man in the world. And he had one little daughter. He loved his daughter very much. He loved three things more than anything else in the world. First one, his little daughter. Second one, the rose garden. And third one, gold. Nothing gave him more pleasure than seeing his little daughter picking roses in the garden, and she placed that roses in the golden vase to decorate the palace. The little princess did not have a mother, so she too much loved her father more than anybody else in the world. One day, king was walking in the garden and he saw a old fellow, the old man, asleep among the flowers. Then, taking pity on the old fellow, king let him go without punishment. The old man was actually a forest god. He was pleased with king's kindness and decided to reward him. He offered the king to wish for anything he desired. King, greedy as he was, quickly wished without thinking that everything he touched be turned into gold. This would clearly make him the richest man in the world. The forest god kept his promise and said, "Starting tomorrow morning with the sun rays, you will get the golden touch." And at the break of the day, he jumped out the bed. That moment he touched the floor, it turned to gold. Then he touched his bed pillow, the chair, and like magic, everything turned into the beautiful yellow gold. The king's heart began to race, and he rushed out of the palace and straight to his garden. He ran round the garden and touching everything he could see. The pebbles, flower, everything he could see. And everything turned into gold. The excitement was too much to handle. Then after a while, he sat down for breakfast. But as soon as he touched the fruit, the cake, the glass of water, everything turned into gold. The king had the most lavish feast, but he could not eat a bite of it. He was getting extremely hungry, but he could not drink and eat gold. He was worried. Just then, his beautiful daughter came running into the room and he hugged her. That time he realized that his lovely daughter at his touch turned hard and fast into gold statue. All her smiles had frozen into gold. The king bowed his head and started crying. He was perhaps the richest man, but in reality, he was worse than the poorest person. He could not eat his food, and now his only child had turned into a statue. There were no more smiles left in his golden world. That time, the forest god came and asked him if he was happy with his golden touch. The king shook his head sadly and said that he was the most miserable man. The king cried and asked for forgiveness. He said, "I will give up all my gold. Please give me my daughter back." The forest god smiled and said, "You have become wiser than before." The king begged the god to take away his gift. The forest god took pity on the king and told him that his touch could be removed by bathing in the holy magical river that nearby the hills. The king Midas quickly went and took a dip in that river. That time he returned to his normal life. He rushed back to his palace and hugged his daughter. The king learned a lesson which he never forget for the rest of his life. So this is the story. The king Midas discovers that the ability to turn object into gold is more of a curse than a blessing. So this is our story. So please read this story twice.